الصيام والقرآن both يشفعان للعبد يوم القيامة. Both they intercede for the person in the day of Qiyamah. الصيام والقرآن. And they're always associated or together. And this is in the context of Ramadan, of course, it's very obvious. And in this hadith of the Prophet والسلام, which is a sound hadith, the Prophet والسلام, he said that they both intercede. الصيام says, منعته الطعام والشراب. I deprived him from eating and drinking. And Al-Qiyam, the night prayer, would say, منعته النوم بالليل. I prevented him, I deprived him from sleeping during the night. So فَيَشْفَعَانَ, so both will intercede. That means they defend the ones that were upon them, the one that used to be upon these two acts of ibadah. Al-A'mal or actions in this life, this is what the human being is all about. The physical body will be buried, will decay, there's no significance to it at the end. What counts are the actions that we do on the face of earth. Fasting is not a physical, something physical, tangible that you can hold fast to it, but it will be in the day of judgment. Al-Qiyam, the same way. Salah, the A'mal. And as the Prophet والسلام, he said, Al-Baqarah wa Ali Imran, both the two longest surah in the Quran, يَأْتِيَانِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, they come in the day of judgment. كَغَمَامَتَانِ أَوْ غَيَيَتَانِ أَوْ كَفَرْقٍ مِنْ طَيْرٍ صَوَافٍ, like two clouds, heavy, light, and like flock of birds. تُحَجَّانِ عَنْ صَاحِبِهِمَ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ, would defend its صَاحِبِهِمَ. And the صاحب is something for us to reflect upon. The صاحب of the two surahs al-Baqarah wa al-Imran. The owner of, صاحب meaning the owner of, the companion of, that means they never leave him and he never leaves them. In this dunya, they're always with him, reciting, memorizing, implementing, acting upon them. And that's why Ahlul Qur'an, the people of the Qur'an, are not necessarily those who have the Qur'an memorized. As the ulama mentioned, one of them, Ibn Qayyim and others. Ahlul Qur'an are the ones that apply the Qur'an in their lives. People that they follow the Qur'an. The Qur'an, the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is their guide. And of course, the Qur'an, meaning the Qur'an and the Sunnah of the Prophet والسلام, they understand that this is the wahy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that they follow. And because of that, they are always busy with the Book of Allah. So this is something that in the month of Ramadan, we should practice and exert ourselves to be among those who are in that companionship with the Qur'an. And it doesn't matter whether a person even doesn't know how to read Qur'an, each one according to their level. So if someone doesn't know how to read, then to put the effort, hours, to learn how to read. If a person knows how to read, to perfect it. And this is one aspect of ubudiyyah, one aspect of act of worship towards the Qur'an. One part of the nasiha, the concern that we have should have towards the Qur'an. There is the understanding the meaning of it, reflecting upon the meaning of it, after we understand the meaning of it in the proper way. Not any one here or there, they can just say in the Qur'an with whatever words and whatever understanding that they have. And Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, he has a famous quote. He said, أَيُّ أَرْضٍ تُقِلُّنِي وَأَيُّ سَمَاءٍ تُظِلُّنِي إِن كُلْتُ فِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ مَا الْأَعْلَى. And this is Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, the rest of this ummah. He said, what earth would carry me, what skies would be above me, if I would say in the Book of Allah without knowledge. That means a person has to have knowledge before he speak about the Qur'an. Knowledge meaning he has learned it. Not because it feels good, it sounds good. Reflecting upon the ayat that talks about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the ayat of Allah in the heavens and in the earth and to establish the deen of Allah, this is definitely something to be for a Muslim, to have his heart attached and affected by it. But the word of sahib al-Qur'an, this is a concept that we need to make sure that it doesn't slip away from us. To be among those who are companions of the Qur'an or owners of the Qur'an. Doesn't leave us anywhere we go with the deeds to be done with it. And the Prophet also said in the sound hadith, it's a Hassan hadith, where the believer when he's resurrected in the Day of Judgment, يَلْقَى نَالْعَبْدَ لَيَلْقَى الْقُرْآنِ, he will meet the Qur'an in the Day of Judgment. كَرَجُلٍ شَاحِبْ اللَّوْنِ, like a man with pale skin color on his face. He's pale but looks tired. So he say, أَمَا تَعْرِفُنِي, he would say, do you know me? He said, who are you? He said, أَنَا الْقُرْآنِ, I am the Qur'an, الذي أضمأتك في الجواهر في الهواجر وأسهرت ليلك. أم the Quran, the one that made you thirsty in الهواجر. الهواجر الهاجرة is the midday. The Quran made you or made that person thirsty in the middle of the day. This is what the Quran basically, why we fast. يا أيها الذين آمنوا كتب عليكم الصيام كما كتب على الذين من قبلكم لعلكم تتقون. آية in the Quran, the entire Ummah fast because of one ayah in the Quran. You see the power of the Quran. أضمأت هواجرك. I made you thirsty in the midday. What the Quran. And I made you spend long hours during the night. Struggling, you want to, you would rather sleep. Anybody can do something else at this moment. Many things can be done. But a person to choose to stand in ibadah, in worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, doing what in the salah? The best part of the salah is al-qunut, not the dua of al-qunut. Al-qunut, in the hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam, afdalu salah, tul al-qunut. The best of the salah is the long qunut, the long standing. Because this is the ashraf, the most honorable thing, part of the salah when a person listens or recites the Quran. The best position is when a person in sujood is closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But the Quran when it's recited, that's why the more the Quran recited in the salah, the more virtue it is. So the point of reference here in this hadith, he said, أَنَا صَاحِبُكَ الْقُرَانِ. He said, I am your sahib, I'm your companion. And the ulama, they said that he is shahib al-lawn, or he's pale, as a sign of how that believer used to be in this dunya, used to be in this world. The Quran made him pale in color. What does that mean? He's fasting. He doesn't look as the healthiest person when he's fasting. He's spending hours of the night making salah. So as a result of that, the Quran will be the first thing that you would see in the Day of Judgment, and will be the shafa'ah, the intercession of the Quran coming with him to defend him in the Day of Judgment. These ahadith should not be only looked at as a certain group of people. This is every Muslim should have a share of this, with whatever level we have. Just the fact that a person follows the Quran, this is something that we need to develop and increase and seek rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by establishing this. And this is how the Prophet ﷺ, this is how the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, and we are in the month of Ramadan, the month of the Quran, where we should definitely seek help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have the best share and to continue the rest of our life with holding fast to the Book of Allah and following the Book of Allah, because it's either for one side or against the person. Some people, they would enter the hellfire because of the Quran. The Quran came with the evidences, with the clear evidences, but they didn't follow the Quran. The Quran becomes the reason for them, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ, to enter the hellfire. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us among the people of the Quran, to make us among those for the Quran, and to seek for them in the Day of Judgment. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَ وَبَارَكَ عَلَى مُحَمَّدٍ وَصَحْبِهِ.